Hey there! Have you ever been stuck, not sure whether to use Git Merge, Git Rebase, or squash your commits? Trust me, you're not the only one. Today, we're going to tackle these sometimes puzzling Git topics. We'll break down the key differences between these Git commands and when to use each for our workflow. If you ever work on a Git project with a bunch of branches, you've probably had to figure out how to get changes from a feature branch back to the main branch, or keep the feature branch up to date with the main branch. The big question is, should we use Git Merge, Git Rebase, or squash our commits? Let's pull back the curtain and see what's really going on with each one. So let's say we've created a new feature branch from main. We've added commits A, B, and C on the feature branch. At the same time, the main branch has added commits D and E. Picture is like two branches of a tree growing in different directions. Keeping our feature branch up to date with main is a crucial part of the Git workflow. We can do this with either Git Merge or Git Rebase. Here's what that means. Git Merge pulls in the latest changes from main into the feature branch, creating a new merge commit in the process. It's like tying the two branches together with a knot. Git Rebase changes the base of a feature branch to the latest commit on main, and then we place our changes from there. It gives us a clean, straightforward commit history, which many people prefer. Now, once we finish developing the feature, we'll want to get the feature branch back into the main branch. We have a few options for this. First is Git Merge. Git will create a new merged commit that ties together the histories of both branches. It's like creating a knot in the rope that shows where the branches joined. But if we do this a lot, we end up with lots of knots, which can make the history a bit messy. Another option is Git Rebase and Forward Merge. We can use Git Rebase to move our feature branches changes onto the tip of main, and then perform a fast forward merge. This is like straightening out the rope so it's all in one line. Now the last option is squash commit. With squashing, all the feature branch commits are squeezed into a single commit when merged into main. This keeps main's history linear, like rebasing, while still creating a single merge commit. But remember, we lose the fine details of individual feature commits in the main branch commit history. Now that said, squashing commits is a popular strategy on platforms like GitHub because it allows us to tidy up history in the main branch while still preserving the detailed commit history in the feature branch. It is kind of like a hybrid approach. Before we wrap up, I would love to know, have you used these strategies before? Which one do you prefer and why? Let's have a discussion in the comments below. To sum it up, Git Merge gives us a complete picture of the commit history and branch evolution. Git Rebase tidies up history by moving commits to the main branch tip. Squashing commits consolidates commit into one, providing a clean, linear history in the main branch, but at the cost of detailed commit history. Now imagine a scenario where the team values a clean, straightforward history, but doesn't mind losing the detailed history of individual commits within the main branch. In this case, squashing commits might be the way to go. But remember, it's all about assessing the pros and cons and deciding which workflow makes the most sense for the team. There's no one-size-fits-all approach. It all comes down to what you value most. If you like our videos, you might like our system design newsletter as well. It covers topics and trends in large-scale system design, trusted by 450,000 readers. Subscribe at blog.bybygo.com.